All right, guys, so the first thing that you definitely need to have is a website. So there are tons of ways to do this, but the easiest way, and I'm going to show you every step right here, is using a website called Wix. So what Wix is a very easy website builder. So instead of going and finding a developer, you would typically have to do and pay them to code your website. That's a couple $1,000 process right there. And it takes a long time, and then if something breaks or you want to change something, you can't do it without their help. So what Wix does is you literally drag and drop templates. You can choose from their templates to start, and it's completely free. And then once you want to purchase your website, it takes Wix's logos off your website, and then it's entirely yours, and it's really cheap every month. But I'll show you all that. Long story short, the first thing we're going to do here, I just put this link to Wix.com. in the previous little section there, so you should have this open in a new tab. All we're gonna do is come to Wix, start my website. It'll ask you to log in or sign up, and then once you do so, what you're gonna do is sign up, and then it'll bring you right to here. What kind of website do you wanna create? So what we're gonna do is whatever is most relevant to you. What I'm gonna do for this example is business. Oh, just log in here. Okay, and then you have two options. So Wix ADI is using artificial intelligence. It asks you questions and then it creates a website for you. I'm not a fan of that. I'm gonna actually go with the create your own website. And now let me just explain real briefly why. Because this Wix just creates something that you may not like, and then you have to turn on editor and basically go back and do this after they've already made it in a specific way. So long story short, if you go over here, you can do choose a template. And let's click that, and now you can choose what you really like and then go from there and start changing the pieces. So, I mean, these are all really good options. This is probably your best bet right here. This first one right here, the consultant, that's the one I use for my service business right now, and it looks great. But you have tons of options. You can choose anything you really like. And if you want to see what they look like to test them, you can hit view. And then you can see what it's really like. And see how clean and professional this looks? So all we're going to end up doing is choosing the one that we like and then going in and just changing the names, changing what's on the pages, things like that. That's what's so great about Wix. So let's say you can see it in mobile as well, which is pretty cool as well. So you can see all that. So if you don't like that, just X out and go select a different one and view it until you find one that you like. So there are tons of categories over here, so you have a lot to choose from. And you can change, if you selected business, you can change it to photography, whatever you like. But say, let's just go back with this one. View, you like it. Obviously the price is free. And then you just do edit this site. And then it'll load here for a second. And then it'll bring you into that website, but everything now you can move. So wait for my computer to catch up here. And now you can see everything is drag and drop. So I have developer options turned on. Yours probably won't come turned on initially. That's if you want to start writing code into the website to make it more advanced. You probably won't do that right off the bat, but in the future, if you want to write certain code for, if you want to make your website more, you know, technologically advanced, if you want to make something crazy like integrate Google Maps or something into it, you would turn on developer tools, and then you can actually write code on top of the moving parts. So it's really cool, but that was a new thing that Wix just added. So it should look like this, and as you can see, all these parts are drag and drop. You can move it around, change the color, and then if you make a mistake, you want to go back, just hit the back button, it'll bring it right back. But all we're going to do here is we're going to put in your company's name up top, and then I'll show you a few things here, but you can change the font, the actual font, to whatever you like. And then you can change the color of it right here. You can change it to whatever color you like. And I'm actually, yeah, that looks perfect. And let's go back to edit text. You can change the size right here. Basically, everything you would need to do is very self-explanatory with Wix. It's really, I mean, you just pick, it can add effects. All this stuff that you can figure out yourself when you go through here, I don't want to waste a lot of time. One thing that I do want to note is that this little link button is really important. So if you turn that off, when you're in preview, like seeing what it would be like, when someone's on your site and they click it, when they click this, typically when someone clicks your website name, it should bring them back to the home page. So since we just disabled that linking, it's not going to go anywhere. So that's why that was linked initially. You can create it so it goes to wherever you want it to go. So it's supposed to go to home. That's what everyone's used to. So when you go to preview and someone's on your site, they can go and they can go back. It brings them right back to home. And you notice small things that you just have to look out for, like when I linked that, it put an underline underneath. It just did that naturally. So just turn that underline off. That's all. But just little things that you can figure out as you go forward with that. But so we'll change the name, and then here's all your different pages up top, and they're also up here. So you can see all the different pages. You can do manage pages. So you can add in different pages, and then it'll add it right up top here. So if we wanted to add a page called gallery, maybe you have examples of your work. So gallery, it would add it right up there. Now if we don't want it to be first, we want it to be right before contact, all we would do is just drag it right before contact. Easy as that. It's very simple. So let's go right back to our homepage. And as you can see, these are background strips, or what this guy standing on this mountain is, and they're all editable. So you can click all these things and you can edit them individually. So what's really cool, and I love that Wix does, is on the background strip, you can put settings, like a parallax. So what that does, if you have none on, and you do preview, it's just gonna stay exactly how it is, right? But if you go and turn on that parallax, it adds this really nice professional touch to the website, and you have a few other options as well that you can choose from, but the parallax does this. So let's select parallax, let's go to preview. And you see this nice, like, it moves slowly, but then this little footer comes up. It just looks really nice, and it adds a nice touch to your website. So small things like that, you would typically have to code into your website, but with Wix, you can do it literally with drag and drop. It just makes it so simple. So what you're gonna do is just go through all of these pages, and you can modify things, you can delete things. All you do is select, and then hit the delete button. It'll delete that, and if you wanted to add something different in there, you can do add. You can add shapes to create boxes, text, images, lists, grids. You can do all different things. Interactive, you can add a different strip. And there's a lot you can do here. So if say you want to add, let's just say you want to add this right here. You wouldn't put your contact right at the top, but if you wanted to, let's just drag it right over here. Put it in, preview, see what that looks like. And now you have a strip right there. So it still has the extra strip. Remember the one that we just deleted that blue off of? Well, it left it in here. So what you'll do is just go back in and we'll get rid of that. So we'll select the whole strip, hit delete. And now that's gone. Now it's still gonna have the gap there. So these are little issues you're gonna run into, but I'll show you how to take care of them. So you still have that gap there. There's nothing in the space, and it's like, what's why? So here's how you fix that. Back to editor, and then we're actually gonna zoom out. I'll show you it on a big scale. And what you can do is you can either do one of two things. You can drag this up, or you can do delete space. Now when you go back, preview, voila, it's all gone. So these are just small things that you're gonna run into as you get on with this. But hopefully that answers some of the questions. And then if you have any specific questions about this, shoot me a message, either in the discussion board or a private message, and I'll get back to you and I'll answer it for you real quick. But there are a ton of resources all over the web on specific things on Wix. I just wanted to give you a general overview. And then just know that you really only need, if you want a very basic website, you don't need all of these things up top. They're good to have, and you don't have to have a lot on each page. You can have a very... like, see how short this page is? It's extremely short. That's all you need. But you could get away with one page entirely. And what it's called is a long tail home page. So if you had none of these up top, you would just have your company name, kind of what you do, and then some general information, maybe what services you have, about us, how to get like pricing, and then how to get in touch or how to book. That could be one page, and that would be very sufficient for your website. That's all you would need. So Wix makes these really cool things for, they're called forms. But what you do is you can have the email, this is actually mine right here, but you can have the email go to wherever you like. So when someone's on your website and they fill out the form, so if you don't have a booking system in place, or you just want people to be able to get in touch with you, when they fill out their name, email, whatever message they want to send, it'll go right to your email address or whatever email address you put in there. So it's a really neat feature that Wix puts in for free. And then you can actually, you can manage fields. So if you want name and item number or order number, anything like that, all you do is just add a field, custom field. Let's see where that one just went, right here. So you could just put in like order number, done, and then come over here. You can make it mandatory, so they have to put in their order number. And I think that's pretty much it for that. Yeah, so that's good. Perfect. So then you can add in things like that, and you can remove things. Like, say we don't need subject, let's just delete that. Come back out, go to preview, see what it looks like. Perfect. So we'll get their name, email, order number, and then what they have to say about it. Then it'll send right to your email address. So that's great. You can throw in kind of where you're located. That's free from Wix. All you would do for that is, I know I was talking about the Google Maps with the coding before, but if you need to get like distance algorithms and things, you would have to code that. But all you would do is just come in here, and it's in contact, and you can throw in a Google Map right there, and it'll just show where you're located. But just go around and play with all of these things. There's so many different add-ons that you can add into your website, and they're all free on the Wix website. So play around in here, get creative with it, but this should give you a gist of how to get started with the Wix. And if you have any questions on it, just feel free to let me know.